week it was Doug Gilbert, Tommy Rich, and they were out here causing all kind of problems as we had title matches galore. Today we have a sensational opening bout as Doug Gilbert will be facing Brian Christopher in action. Let's take a listen to what they had to say.
Like I said last week, the days of Tommy Wildfire Rich and Dangerous Doug Gilbert shaking hands and kissing babies are all over. Jerry Lawler, Tex Slasinger, PG-13, you all found out last week. Well, this week, Brian Christopher, it's time for you to pay the ultimate price.
Doug Gilbert, once a snake, always a snake. You might have had a lot of other people fooled, but not me. Today, you're going to step into the ring with another snake, but this one's going to bite you first.
Ready for our opening bout today here on USWA Championship Wrestling. First introducing, at a weight of 236 pounds, out of Lexington, Tennessee, Dangerous Doug Gilbert. And in his corner, Scott Bowden. His opponent today making his way to the ring area now, at a weight of 223 pounds, out of Memphis, Tennessee, Too Sexy, Brian Christopher. Bill Rush is the official referee over to Lance and Dave, our opener today.
Hello again, everybody. Lance Russell with Dave Brown and Corey Macklin, ready to go with another big USWA Championship Wrestling as we're opening up with truly one of those marquee matches with Christopher and Gilbert, and we've seen some great battles with them, Dave.
We have indeed. A couple of guys who will go at each other tooth and nail, you can bet, for the entire match. That's not all we got today. We've got Tracy Smothers and Jesse James Armstrong. They'll be going against PG-13 right here today. What's Doug Gilbert doing? He's out insulting someone in the audience. Oh, about getting back in the ring. Let's get the match underway. Also returning to the USWA after an absence of some time on television here, the Spellbinder will be back. Coco Beware will be along later on, the Birdman too. Lots of other things coming up today. You stay with us throughout as we're now underway with a great opening fight. Look at this, Brian Christopher using the right fist. Doug Gilbert's head slammed into the turnbuckle. It staggers Doug. Brian with a slide out of the ring. Boom, big right hand.
Last week, Dave, of course, PG-13 regained the tag titles. And we've got a story to tell you about PG-13, as you'll be seeing them a little bit later. They'll be going against the team of Tracy Smothers and Jesse James Armstrong. What a lineup of action, and we're already into it as Doug Gilbert pops back up in the ring, reaches out, slaps Brian Christopher, and nobody slaps Brian and gets away with it. Foot to the midsection, pounds him with a right hand. Scott Bowden having a fit on the outside.
Oh, suplex by Brian Christopher.
I think Bill Rush has got some money on Brian Christopher on this match. He's letting him get away with everything.
He may be getting away with a few things, but Doug Gilbert will also try to get away with a few things from time to time, too. That was Scott Bowden over here yelling in the microphone that you heard. He's over at Doug Gilbert's corner. Bulldog by Brian Christopher. Down to the mat goes Doug Gilbert. Christopher so far pretty well controlling the action. Doug Gilbert dragged out in the middle of the ring by Brian. Putting the heat on that left leg.
Grapevine that leg and it pounded it down. Christopher and Gilbert, as always, they really go at each other and have been one of the great feuds the USWA has ever seen. Pow! And look at that Gilbert swing that right hand. Tommy Rich came back, Dave, and son of a gun, the attitudes just changed overnight.
Oh, I know it. He and Gilbert together really been causing problems in recent days in the USWA. Dangerous Doug favoring that left leg, looking for sympathy from the crowd, not finding any. Brian back on his feet. Doug backs him to the ropes. Reversal by Brian Christopher. But Doug Gilbert, ooh, hammers him down to the mat.
There's a cover one, two, and a foot on a rope. Christopher legitimately had the foot up on the rope, and that was the one that stopped the count right there at two. Gilbert now. Leg over the head, and look at Bowden grabs him from the outside. Brian Christopher undergoing some real pounding from Gilbert. Got him outside the ring, down on the floor, while Bowden distracts the referee. This gives Gilbert an opportunity to put Brian into that ring post. Opening match on what will prove to be a sensational program today.
What's your bone right here? What's the bone?
And again, Brian Christopher hammered right at that.
How you like your boy 260 now?
Get him back in, Bill. Christopher rolled in, and Gilbert follows right in behind him. And Gilbert scoring solidly on Christopher, staggers him over to the ropes.
Christopher whipped across the way, but comes up with the foot, and that slows down Doug Gilbert. Early in the match, it had been all Brian Christopher. Then Doug Gilbert sort of took over. It was a nice move by Brian, sort of left Gilbert hanging in midair. Back in the turnbuckles, a whip across the way. Brian Christopher sets with a foot. He comes up with a kick behind the head. Doug thought he had him blocked, but he didn't.
It's kind of like stepping in a stirrup and swinging your leg up over a horse, and Brian wheeled around. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Over the top and hits referee Bill Rust flush.
Doug ducked out of the way, and it was right into the referee. Doug Gilbert, you can see that chain. I mean, he's not even attempting to hide it. The referee is down, rolling on the mat. Doug Gilbert with a chain wrapped around the right hand. Scott Bowden up on the apron. Doug has just tossed the chain now out to Scott Bowden. Bowden celebrating the imminent victory. But the referee is out of the ring, down on the floor. You're not a referee. We're not ringing the bell.
Scott Bowden jumps in and counts 1, 2, 3 after he ripped him.
Here's T.D. Steele. T.D. Steele is a referee. Is he? All right, well, Randy Hales has sent T.D. Steele in since Bill Rush was knocked out. T.D. looks like he's going to be the referee in the ring. And, yeah, it should have been the disqualification right there, if you ask me, with Bowden dancing around in the ring.
Brian caught Gilbert with that kick, drops down with that flying leg drop. Here he comes, 1, 2, and Bowden, that's got to be a disqualification.
Got to be.
There. He nails T.D. Steele right in the middle of the back from the outside, and Gilbert hammers Christopher from behind. Bowden off with a shoe, nails Gilbert, down he goes. Christopher puts the super kick on Bowden. Here comes Armstrong and Smothers going after Christopher. T.D. Steele face down in the ring where he was the substitute referee after Bill Rush got knocked down. And now Bill Rush looking from across the ring. I think he indicated ring the bell, but I'm not sure. Pile driver. Christopher caught in a pile driver from Doug Gilbert, and with the help of Armstrong, Smothers, Bowden, here comes Wolfie into the ring along with a spout.
Starting of what's going to happen last wrestle.
As we still do not know exactly what, Dave. I think we'll have to call it a disqualification or a stop match, one of the two.
Well, to, as far as I'm concerned, it would almost have to be a disqualification. Two referees hit. My goodness, one of them was accidental, but then there was no doubt that Bowden just went after T.D. Steele. That should be a disqualification and a fine right
Absolutely.
There for Mr. Bowden.
We'll take time out. Be back. We've got PG-13 Smothers and Armstrong coming up.
All right. Well, I tell you what, off to a wild start here today with Brian Christopher against Doug Gilbert and a disqualification on Gilbert.
As we said a little bit earlier, last week, Dave, PG-13 got their titles back. They were defending against the Rock and Roll Express down at the Coliseum on last week's Monday night show. And then what happened is PG-13 came out to the ring. They got jumped, and Jamie got his leg hurt. It ended up with Brian Christopher substituting for Jamie in there. They retained the USWA tag titles. Let's take a look at some of that action coming back from the Coliseum.
Champions, J.C. and Wolfie, PG, hey! Running to ringside with a metal chair, and Rich and Gilbert Bowden working over the leg of J.C. Ice. Come on. As PG-13 making their way to the ring area, and you guys just going to stand here and look and laugh at that stuff. Rock and Roll Express. Yeah, real funny. And you just stand there and watch somebody get hurt. Here comes some help. Here's Brian Christopher in the spellbinder out.
Look. I can tell you right now, Randy Hales, you know me well enough, and I ain't forfeit. Those are my titles, and if I have to do this, I will get in there. I've worked too long and too hard, and those are my belts, and I'll get in there by myself and defend those titles if I got to do that.
I know you got a big match with the belts at stake, and I'll tell you what I'll be willing to do. Randy Hales, listen to me. Wolfie D. For this match right here, I've told you before a lot of things. I told you not to trust Doug Gilbert, Tommy Rich, but you went out and did it, and I said that when you did that, I would never help you because you wouldn't listen to me. But right now, I'm willing to go back on that, and I'll tell you right now, I'll be your partner in this match right now.
Whoopee gets the tag. Here he comes. Here comes his sexy. Christopher, nailing away on the Rock and Roll Express. Brian pops the head together, Rick and Robert. Wolfie's got Morton. Brian's got Gibson. And they slam them into each other. Working together well as a team of two sexy Brian Christopher. And Wolfie D. Harley and Brian pounding away on Robert Gibson over in the corner. Whoopie D and Ricky Morton out on the floor fighting it out. Christopher bags Gibson up into the ropes. Ooh. Oh, boy. Comes from behind with that big kick. Christopher climbing the rope. Here comes Coco Ware. And Coco Christopher down at 11-11. Coco comes in. Oh no! Puts that bird buster on Brian Christopher. Here's J.C. Ice. J.C. with that leg all banded up in there. Here comes Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert. Working over that leg immediately, the first thing he goes for. I'm trying to hurt the guy. That kind of stuff is absolutely ridiculous. Let me tell you. Tommy Rich immediately going for an injury to try to hurt J.C. Ice. Pounding away with that chair. Doc Gilbert just now referee Frank Morrell. Frank is down. Woofie in the middle of the ring. Doc Gilbert drops down. Doc Gilbert. Scott Woofie busts it open. Scott Bowden's putting his 2 cents in it. And Gilbert. Come on, Doc. These guys, let me tell you. Rich Gilbert, Coco Ware, Paul driving Christopher out on the floor. Come on. Working over the leg of J.C. Ice. Here comes the King and Tex Lazinger in.
Okay, we are ready for tag team action here on USWA Championship Wrestling. First introducing, led to the ring by their manager, Scott Bowden, coming in at a combined weight of 493 pounds, and hailing from Springfield, Tennessee, Tracy Smothers, and his partner out of Marietta, Georgia, Jesse James Armstrong. And now, here's a word from their opponents.
You know, man, J.C. Ice's leg is hurt. The doctors have told me. The nurses have told me. The promoters told me. Even J.C. Ice's own mama said, don't wrestle, man. It could ruin your career. But J.C. Ice is not a quitter, and I'm going to wrestle today. And Rich and Gilbert, I'm looking for you as soon as I get done with Jesse James and Tracy Smothers.
They're coming in at a combined weight of 399 pounds from the hood. J.C. Ice, Whoopie D, PG-13. On their way to the ring, Bill Rush is referee. Over to Lance Russell and Dave Brown.
Okay, Corey. And the beat goes on. I want to tell you, PG-13, Armstrong and Smothers. That's what we've got in today, but you can look it around. Rock and Roll Express, Gilbert and Rich. A lot of tag team action involving around the USWA tag champs. J.C. Ice and Wolfie D. Pull the belts off. This is a non-title bout. Bill Rush has the belts, and Wolfie D will be starting out. I am sure they'll be looking to use Wolfie as much as possible in that ring.
I'm sure they'll have to, because I was just watching J.C. Ice over in the corner, and he is not getting around very well at all on that left leg of his. So I'm sure that Wolfie and J.C. will try to keep J.C. in the corner as much as possible.
PG-13 from the hood. Where exactly is the hood, Dave? I don't know. You know, I'm not sure where it is, but I bet it's a far cry from Germantown, isn't it?
I was going to say, I bet you don't go that way too much, huh?
Tell
you what, Scott Bowden.
Here's a perfect example of what we have always observed about PG-13. They are just letting that youthful enthusiasm and invincibility in their own mind carry away. JC should not be up there in that ring wrestling. He's been told by everybody but us, so we just will add our two bits to it. And here he is coming in here in a match because he wants to show that he is a tough son of a gun, and he is. But he also may end up with finding another line of work when that leg get stomped on again. Jesse James Armstrong squaring off with Wolfie D as Jesse is back over talking to his partner Tracy Smothers. This is a very good tag team, Smothers and Armstrong.
Oh, they're formidable, even when the PG-13 is at full strength. They're facing a very, very difficult match. And with J.C. Ice hurt, that's going to make it that much more difficult. Wolfie, he made the tag. Here comes J.C. Ice. That leg is hurting him. There's no doubt about it. He had to get right back out of there quickly. Wolfie D is not going to have much chance to rest in this match. He is going to have to spend most of the time in the ring. J.C., I think, took that tag and came in there just to prove he could get in the ring. as if to say to folks like Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert, jump me from behind if you want to, whatever, but you're not going to keep me out of the action.
Got to be not so comforting to his partner, Wolfie D, to know that he may not be able to depend on the tag when he most needs it. Jesse misses. Wolfie does not. Catches him with a clothesline. Puts Armstrong down. Whoa. All the way over the top rope. And the referee is not going to stop it because, look at this. Went with a Frankensteiner right out here on the floor as Wolfie nailed Jesse James Armstrong with that Frankensteiner and took him right down on the studio floor.
He was out of bounds. That should be a timeout.
There's no timeout. There's no out of bounds. And as far as over the top rope goes, it was momentum that carried him over. It wasn't like Wolfie picked up and threw him over. You know, we can't give you timeout. Talk to the referee. There's no timeout.
There's always timeout. This crowd's making too much noise.
I think this is a football game or something. There's no timeout. Get him back in the ring. He's got a 10 count. That's part of it. If he doesn't get back in there, you lose.
It was up to 8, and the referee was tolling away. Smothers got Armstrong over, rolled him under the ropes. That breaks the count, and he's back out on the floor again as he was really nailed. Wolfie came flying off the ring apron right into a Frankensteiner, which is one that can really do you in, and it did Jesse James Armstrong. Wolfie tying it up, and look at Smothers, goes behind. Wolfie reverses it, rolls him up on the shoulders for a count of 2, and that's it. Some good action in between a lot of this roughhouse stuff, Dave.
Indeed, and Smothers and Armstrong know they're in a battle here, even though it's primarily just against Wolfie D. Again, if you joined us late, J.C. Ice is at ringside. He's here to wrestle, but he has an injured left leg. And it's injured pretty badly, badly enough that he's having a lot of trouble just walking around on it, much less getting in there and wrestling.
Wolfie's carried every bit of the action at the moment, and when you're against a team like Armstrong and Smothers, that is not good. You need the rest, but Wolfie's doing the Iron Man trick as he's staying right in there with it.
Smothers round behind, hammered that left arm up, reversal by Wolfie D. Smothers took Wolfie D's legs out from under him, but Wolfie D immediately back in a hammer position with that left arm, and he retains the advantage. Can he keep it for long, though?
Wolfie D with the arm up behind. Dave, we're going to have to take a break here. The match will continue. We'll be back and join it in just a moment.
Baker, you shut up, kid.
Okay. J.C. Ice took the tag. He's been in. He was in first with Smothers. And Tracy resumes what he was trying to do, and that is grab that leg. J.C. had it hurt by Rich and Gilbert. He really shouldn't be in there wrestling today, but you're not going to tell him that or anything else. And so, PG-13, USWA Tag Champions, going against the rugged team of Tracy Smothers, Jesse James Armstrong. Here comes Doug Gilbert dashing in, and Wolfie chasing him around the ring. And out of the studio area he goes, Dave.
That gave Jesse James Armstrong and Tracy Smothers a chance to double-team J.C. Ice and go after that left leg. Wolfie D in there to even it up. All four of them in the ring right now. Wolfie working on Tracy Smothers. Look out, Doug Gilbert now jumps in the ring. He goes after that leg of J.C. Ice. He got the knee. J.C. Ice rolling in pain on the in the middle of the ring.
Gilbert wheeled in, put the block on that leg, and took right straight on.
The referee never saw him. He was involved otherwise.
Set up, Dave. My Uncle Bobby Badger probably won't set up Doug Gilbert for the Seminoles after that awesome football tackle, baby.
Yeah, maybe.
Dropping down with the elbow on that leg as J.C. Ice now has the problem.
Yep, they've got that left leg in a position now they can really work on it. Look at that. Look at Armstrong dropping down on the leg with his leg. Just adding more and more pressure. This is what everyone had feared. This is why everyone told JC guys, don't go in the ring today. You're supposed to be wrestling.
Yeah, the I told you so that we all want to say to JC is going to help him out one bit as far as it goes. And the bad thing about it, with his leg like that, it's just going to postpone him being back to 100% a lot longer and maybe even more serious than that, to where he could get it screwed up to where he's not going to be able to work again at all. Jesse James Armstrong with a hand on Tracy's head, putting some more weight down as Tracy with a half crab on JC Ice's left leg. Wolfie wants to come in so bad, and the referee is keeping an eye and keeping him out. He goes with an inside toe hold off of that crab. So Jesse James Armstrong really got in a position where he is looking and he is murdering that leg. And JC has got the problem of getting away, one, two, getting across the ring in order to get over to Wolfie D to make the tag. He's got to do that. We're sitting with about 4 minutes left in our time on this match. It's a time limit, one fall, 15-minute time limit match, Dave.
Well, I tell you what, if they keep J.C. Ice in there the remainder 4 minutes, J.C. is going to have a tough time getting out of this ring without a lot of help from some other folks, because they continue just to really work on that leg. Head for the corner, J.C. He is, but he's heading for the wrong one.
Yeah, he was heading to a neutral corner instead over toward Wolfie, as he is racked with pain. And in the air. Oh, no. Wow. JC.
PG-13 don't have a leg to stand on, do they, Dave?
Oh. Yes, Scott Bowden. Yes, yes. Great one-liner from Mr. Bowden. Yes, yes.
Tag. Tag goes, and in comes Tracy Smothers.
Wolfie D reaching for the tag from the corner. J.C. Ice just not able to get to the corner. Smothers and Armstrong, well, to their credit, I mean, got to give them their due.
Work on an injury.
Sure, and keep your opponent away from getting to the fresh man, the strong man in the ring. There's a count of two. The shoulders are down. Again, you got to hand that one to J.C. Ice. I think I'd have been tempted just to keep the shoulders down and take the three count at that point. J.C. again pulls the shoulder up at the count of two. Time winding down here.
We're down to the two-minute mark, and out. 2 minutes to go in this time limit. As J.C. Ice, what you said, Dave, makes far too much sense, because it's just instinct. When they got your shoulders down, don't let them get the three count.
Right.
You kick them up, and that's what he did. But, okay, they lose one match. They don't want to have to do it, particularly in between the type of feud that's going on with Smothers and Armstrong. J.C. popped the shoulders up, but he'd be a lot better off to go ahead and take the 1-2-3.
Yeah, I think so for the future. And also thinking those belts, they have to be defended. They've got some title matches signed. Is J.C. going to be able to defend in those title matches? All sorts of ramifications here to the injury and to J.C.'s being in there right now. This is exactly what Armstrong and Smothers wanted to see. Once they got J.C. in there, they could... Has he given it up?
60 seconds to go in the time limit.
No, he has not given it up. I thought he had. Bowden was over here yelling he's given it up, but he isn't.
Oh, yeah. Less than a minute to go. If he can make it to the time limit, it will be a draw. And I guess in his mind, he thinks he worked. It's worth it to do it. Figure four leg lock. Oh, man. Of all, we're down to 30 seconds of wrestling time. 30 seconds to go. Referee Bill Rush, 1-2, and the shoulder comes up. J.C. breaking it. That's the count is what I'm talking about. He also...
You son of a...
We are right down to the end of the time limit. As J.C. Ice on the count. That's it.
He gave it up.
No
Nope, nope. No, he didn't. Time limit. It's a draw.
Wolfie with a hubcap going after Tracy Smothers. J.C. Ice survived it. They got the draw. Here comes Gilbert. Gilbert from behind, nailing away on Wolfie D while Bowden goes to the leg of J.C. Ice as Wolfie is hammered into the top turnbuckle. And if nothing else, retroactively, I would have to disqualify. Here comes Brian Christopher. He evens things up. And he takes some pressure off of J.C. Ice and Wolfie D. But here comes Coco Beware. Good night. He's got a bullwhip in his hand, and he hammers down on Brian Christopher while Tracy Smothers goes for that Confederate flag and standard and beats on the leg of J.C. Ice.
Brian Christopher being hit with that bullwhip by Coco Beware, the flagpole hitting the leg again and again of J.C. Ice, that injured left leg. Meanwhile, Doug Gilbert's got Wolfie D tied up and out of the action, and Jesse James Armstrong hammers him in the top of the head with a hubcap.
While Coco continues to swing the bullwhip, that shows you the kind of volatility there is in the USWA right now. It takes very little to ignite a spark of mayhem all over anywhere these guys are gathered, because there are so many bad feelings between the participants. It was officially a draw. Gilbert on Wolfie, Coco on Brian Christopher, Smothers and Armstrong and Bowden on J.C. Ice.
I think we ought to take a break and come back and get this sorted out while we're away. We'll be right back.
You were correct, Mr. David. It took several people to get J.C. Ice out of here. He was not in good shape. Don't know how that's going to affect the future plans, as you pointed out, with titles to defend and all that sort of thing. Brian Christopher had to be helped out of here, too, with Coco Beware using that bullwhip on him. Randy Hales, for his effort to try to get things straightened around, he got jumped, and he was able to walk out of here. But,
yeah, but he was attacked by Coco with a bullwhip, too. That is ridiculous stuff.
I want to tell you, our good colleague Dean Hill from up in Louisville way was in the Nashville studios the other day with Wildfire Tommy Rich and Dangerous Doug Gilbert. Let's hear what Dean got out of those two guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, you all just saw the situation that occurred on television. We're here in the Nashville studios. We've called in the Dangerous One and Wildfire Tommy Rich. Gentlemen, if you join me here and on screen, comment about the situation that's going on. I don't want to talk about the past, because we have the past, all that's beyond us. But here in the last year or so, you guys have become pretty much fan favorites here in the USWA. But it's a situation that's occurred where a lot of the fans might consider that you actually stowed the belt. Tommy, I'd like to have your comments on it.
You know, the bottom line is people talking about stealing belts. This is a man's game. Jerry Lawler, you stepped in the ring. You got beat 1, 2, 3. Take it like a man. You and me go way back to begin with, Jerry Lawler. I was the only man to ever shave the king's head right there in Memphis, Tennessee. You know, you go crying and hollering to the people and everything else. You know, all of the people like Jerry the King Lawler. He can't do no wrong. Well, Doug Gilbert, myself, we might not be kids. Kissing no babies and may hugging nobody's necks, but when we say we're gonna get the job done, we do it, don't we, Dougie?
Yeah, a lot of people, Doug, saw your actions in regards to the film footage that they just saw. Might want to consider it to be a sneak attack. I'd like to have your version of it.
You know, Dean Hill, you're a pretty smart man, right? When you say, okay, everybody don't seem to see what really happens behind the scenes. J.C. Ice, Wolfie D, Brian Christopher, Jerry Lawler. Everybody sees the people hollering, yeah, 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 yeah. Well, back when I needed a friend, back when I really needed a friend, everybody wasn't out there going, yeah, 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 yeah. I had one friend in the world. And you zoom this camera in right over here,
and you will see who that friend was. Now, let me tell you something. Before the people started going, go, Doug, go, or go, Wildfire, go, we were still doing it. We was the meanest. We was the toughest. Y'all loved to hate us. Y'all threw cans at us. You busted our windows. It don't matter. You can like us or you cannot like us. One way or the other, it just don't matter. See, what you see behind the scenes ain't what you see out in public. You see Randy Hales pull up behind the building. None of the fans sees that. Who hops out of the car with him? Whoopie D, JCS. Well, Randy Hales gets out and grabs their bags and carries me and says, come on, boys, you can do it tonight. You're my champions. Right on, boys. Then he says, too sexy, Brian Christopher, you the man. Come on, you can go. Eddie Marlin says you can do it. You do it. Well, boys, that's not what the USWA is about. You're looking at it. You're looking. We got robbed. They stole the belts from us. And all I can say now is whether you like us or you don't like us, you better get ready to deal with us because it's going to get no more easier. All I can say is hell won't take us and heaven's scared to, so you better count on torture for the future just like Jerry Lawler did.
Well, there we are. Nice sparkling attitude coming out of Dangerous Doug Gilbert and Tommy Wildfire Rich. Let's take a look, Dave. We're back on Wednesday night this coming week down at the Mid-South Coliseum.
7:30 it all begins. Advance tickets are on sale at all Ticketmaster locations and at the Mid-South Coliseum. Right now, opening match of the night, the Border Patrol with Patricia. Don't know a lot about them. We'll be talking to Patricia a little bit later on today. They'll be going against the Spellbinder and Tony Williams in the opening match of the night.
Okay, we're looking at the USWA ladies' title match being right up on the board, as Miss Texas puts it there, going against Patricia's Surprise. Can't say much about that.
Yeah, then Scott Bowden's $2,500 challenge match. We're going to get more details on this coming up a little bit later on, too. Randy Hales in there against somebody. We'll find out later on.
Well, you better believe we're going to try to find out. Bullwhip on the pole. Now, we've seen that bullwhip prominent. It was in the Coliseum last Monday night in the Surprise package. And it was here today. Too Sexy Brian Christopher facing Coco Beware and the bullwhip up on the pole. Go get it. You can use it in the match.
Grudge USWA tag title match, and I am frankly not too sure how well J.C. Ice's leg is going to be healed by Monday, by Wednesday night even. PG-13 will be going, though, against Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert. Is from now until Wednesday enough time for J.C. Ice's leg to recover enough that they can mount a successful title defense? We'll have to find out. Also, you notice Scott Bowden lurking in the background behind Rich and Gilbert there.
That's a good word, lurking in the background, just what he's doing. And the final match Wednesday night at the Coliseum is going to be a wild and woolly one, non-sanctioned eight-man marathon match. Falls count anywhere, anything goes, bring anything, use it. Two referees will be assigned to catch the falls as they take place all over the Coliseum. When Tommy Rich, Doug Gilbert, Tracy Smothers, Jesse James Armstrong, is that a murderer's row or what
sure
right
is
there? Going against PG-13, Brian Christopher, and a mystery partner in that non-sanctioned eight-man marathon. All of that Wednesday right down at the Mid-South Coliseum. This could be a woolly night.
Oh, you're right. Get ready. A lot of blanks still to fill in. We'll do that as we go along. Oh, good grief.
Well, we won't wait long to hear conversation as Scott Bowden.
The garbage man came and picked up all that trash we left laying in the ring. Your big heroes, Brian Christopher and PG-13. Well, I got news for you, boys. It's going to happen again. We're going to kick your butts all over the Coliseum. And when I say we, I do mean we, because I'm going to get my shots in, too. You better believe that, boys.
Well, we know that you're going to be involved in a marathon match.
He'll be involved in a marathon match. Let's see. Four horsemen? No, doesn't fit here. Three amigos? You see, we're missing one. The Three Stooges? Definitely not Lance Russell. Don't mistake me. What we're going to do is the four rednecks, myself, Tracy Smothers, the wild-eyed Southern boy, and Dangerous once again, Doug Gilbert, and Wildfire Tommy Rich is going to catch the Coliseum on fire and beat somebody's brains out.
Now,
Let's get this straight right now. The dominant team in professional wrestling is Jesse James Armstrong and the wild-eyed Southern boy, Tracy Smothers. Tommy Rich, Doug Gilbert, we don't particularly get along, but on this night, we're going to fight together. Eight-man marathon match, 30 minutes. The falls, the one that gets the most falls is the winner. And we don't care who their mystery partner is. It could be King Kong or Godzilla.
Doesn't bother you.
They don't have a snowball's chance. Right, Doug.
You know what, Lance Russell? You've been around here longer than dinosaurs have. Out with the old, in with the cold, Daddy. What's happening? Eight-man marathon match. Now, see, Jerry Lawler, you run that big snoot of yours last week, and you started bringing up my family, which is something that no man walking the face of this green earth does. Now, see, Brian Christopher, you think you've got the stack. You got it stacked against us. You got the deck stacked real high. See, you go to Randy Hells and say, I want to leave this contract open. So I go out and try to find a man that ain't too scared to get in the ring with Dangerous Doug Gilbert and Wildfire Tommy Rich. See, Jerry Lawler, you fought Joe LaDuke all over the Mid-South Coliseum. See, Jerry Lawler, you fought Austin Idol all over the Mid-South Coliseum. Well, this week, Lance Russell, you've seen all of those battles. There's no telling what is going to be brought in the Mid-South Coliseum this Wednesday night, because I'm telling you, four men, myself, Wildfire Tommy Rich, Wild-Eyed Southern Boy Tracy Smothers, and Brian Jesse James Armstrong, PG-13, Brian Christopher, you can go get Godzilla, because it ain't gonna matter. I'm telling you, somebody will leave the Mid-South Coliseum Wednesday night 90% burnt.
You will see them all involved in a 30-minute match. And it's going to be how many falls, who can get the most falls in that 30-minute. Wednesday night, marathon match is going to be a good one. We'll be back in just a moment.
Okay, we're back on USWA Championship Wrestling. Ready for action. One ball, a 10-minute time limit. First introducing, making his first appearance in the USWA, wrestling out of Minneapolis, Minnesota. At a weight of 263 pounds, here is Red Tyler. His opponent today, coming in at 272 pounds, out of Fantasy Island, the Spellbinder. One ball, 10 minutes for this next single bout here on the USWA. Over to David Lane.
Been a while since we've seen the Spellbinder. Mm-hmm. He is back in here against Red Tyler. Let's ring the bell. And there we go. Referee Bill Rush caught me unaware.
Sometimes the mechanism for ringing the bell will kind of hide from us. We have to kind of search for the rope to ring the bell.
We do it the old-fashioned way with our hands.
That's right.
Instead of pushing a button electronically.
You got it.
Tell me, I'm trying to place. It seems to me we had Tyler here once before, but I'm not even certain about it, Dave.
I'm not sure either. I tell you what, he looks like a pretty formidable opponent, though. Size-wise, he looks like he matches up pretty well against Spellbinder. Let's see how he wrestles. Spellbinder reversed back into a corner. Mr. Tyler driving the shoulder to the midsection.
Spellbinder has always been a guy that had superb physical characteristics. And he fired Tyler right into that corner. I mean, turned him up, head down into the mat, facing the mat, and feet up in the air as he whipped him hard. He has great upper body. Well, he's got just great strength because his legs are also very powerful, too. I don't know whether it's attitude. I don't know what it is that he's just missed that gold ring, though. And he's back in here after Tyler catches him in the midair. Nice move. I don't believe that was a good one.
A little raw power showing up there from Spellbinder as he caught Tyler in midair coming off the ropes. Now Tyler back up on his feet, holding on to his back. Spellbinder bounced him off that mat.
Well, What a specimen this guy is. It looks to me like he, although his ring weight is about the same as it was, he looks like he's trimmed down just a little bit, Dave. I think he's taken a couple of pounds off. I believe he got up over 270 at one point.
He's looking pretty strong right now as he's got that left arm barred. Rhett Tyler finds himself on the mat. Referee Bill Rush checking to see about a possible submission. Tyler says, nope, not giving up. But he gets out of it, goes after the spellbinder with a forearm. Lifts the knee. Spellbinder hits the mat. Gets back on his feet quickly, and Tyler is right there. Off the ropes comes the spellbinder. Clothesline by Rhett Tyler.
Tyler now making his best move since the beginning of the match. He's no shrinking violet either. He's physically very well developed, and he has been going after the big guy from Fantasy Island to whip in. He misses that spinning back kick. And Spellbinder follows it up with a ripping right hand, and referee Bill Rush saying, open him up, open him up. There's the whip, Tyler across, and the elbow puts him down. When he puts that upper arm to you, that's a lot of arm behind it.
Boy, it sure is. Tyler picked up in the air now by the Spellbinder. He's slammed right in the center of the ring. Spellbinder with a cover. One, two, it's over, and it's a victory, and a pretty impressive one against some big competition here. The Spellbinder gets the win.
I got to tell you, that little somersault that he does in there, you stop and think for a guy 270 pounds to be able to move that agilely and be able to control his body. Very impressive move. He's looking very good.
Dude. Yes, he is. And can you imagine the opponent being there, and all of a sudden, boom, there's that 270 landing on top of you. It is very difficult to get up after that.
I think Mr. Tyler finds it easier to talk to the fans. You have a guest. I'm curious to find out about Patricia.
Me too. Here is Patricia, new to the USWA right now. Patricia, and you hear words like Patricia and the Border Patrol, and we're kind of anxious to find out a little bit about you and your situation here.
First of all, Mr. Announcer Guy, have you ever seen such a glorious sight like me in your life? I think you have. See, I'm here for two reasons. My first reason is I plan to have the USWA Tag Team titles on my men, the Border Patrol. And they're coming. They're not here now, but shut your mouth, but they're coming. And the second reason, I hear about Miss Texas. She's so big, she's so bad, she fights men. Well, I'm the new woman here. I'm in charge. I come from New York. I take charge in New York, and I'll take charge down here, down south. Miss Texas, you got nothing on me. You're overrated. You're dirt, Miss Texas. You're dirt. And I'm just sick of how everybody makes this big to-do about Miss Texas.
Well, Miss Texas has proven herself time and time again in the ring. Here she is right here. Here's Miss Texas. I'm sure you heard what Patricia had to say.
You know what? I don't know who you are, and I don't care. But USWA is my territory. I wrestle men and women and beat them all. And if you stick your nose in my business, I'm going to knock it off. Because you're going to find out you don't mess with Miss Texas.
Oh, yeah, Miss Texas? Well, let me tell you something. I'm the new woman here. I don't wrestle. I don't like to get my hands dirty. All right? But I got a surprise for you, sister. Oh, yeah. An old friend of yours, Susan Sapphire. What do you think about that, Miss Texas?
Oh, I'm really scared
yeah,
now. I'm shaking my boots now. In my boots, honey.
Here's Susan Sapphire, too.
I'm back, and I'm going to be your worst nightmare.
Oh, look out. Patricia coming out here and immediately causing trouble, insulting Miss Texas, bringing out Susan Sapphire. Here comes Bill Rush trying to get this broken up. Randy Hales, yeah. Got a two against one. Miss Texas when it's even, when it's one against one, a different situation, let me tell you, than what you see right here. Let's take a break, don't you think? We'll be back in just a moment.
Hit her with that first right in the back of the head. Knocked her right down there.
Yeah, we are. Hey, here we go.
30 minutes. Yes. That's Wednesday night.
Wednesday night. Exactly. Wednesday night at Coliseum, 7:30 bell time. Big 8-man non-sanctioned marathon match. Looking forward to that Monday night. That starts off our USWA on tour.
Pardon me for interrupting, but I got to tell you, I love the concept of having a 30-minute time limit. It's there. It's not going to end any earlier than that. And all of the stars will be out there going at each other's throats for the entire 30 minutes, and it's based on who gets the number of falls. The most number of falls can be in the ring and out on the floor, up in the balcony, anywhere.
Yeah, anywhere.
That's going to be a son of a
two referees and the light just come on. I think I said Monday. Wednesday night. It's Wednesday night.
Yes, Wednesday night. Coliseum.
Hey, Friday night, Jonesboro, Arkansas, Earl Bell Community Center on Church Street. 8 o'clock is bell time. USWA Wrestling Jonesboro events tickets on sale at Front Page Cafe. Jerry the King Lawler returns to Jonesboro. The King will be there, along with Tommy Rich, Doug Gilbert on the card, Too Sexy Brian Christopher, and All-Star card is all coming up Friday night, Jonesboro, Arkansas, Earl Bell Community Center right there on Church Street. Saturday night, January 27th, Union City, Tennessee.
Haven't heard that name in a while.
Ooh, a lot of great fans up in Union City. Well, wrestling is coming to you there at the high school. As we always tell you, there's nothing like being there, seeing it live when it comes near you. 8 o'clock is bell time as the USWA returns with 6 big matches, 2 title matches, a mixed tag match, chain match, all on the card. Jerry the King Lawler, PG-13, Brian Christopher, Miss Texas, Rich and Gilbert, all in Union City. Next Saturday night in Union City, Tennessee, Thursday night, February 8th, Trenton, Tennessee, up around Dave's old stumbling ground.
Yes, sir.
National Guard Armory in Trenton, 7:30 bell time. Pick up those advance tickets and be there for action in Trenton, Tennessee, Thursday, February 8th, and Friday night, February 9th, Corinth, Mississippi. National Guard Armory, 8 o'clock bell time in Corinth as the USWA returns there. Pick up those advance tickets there at Captain Nutrition and the other location there on for USWA Wrestling coming to Corinth, Mississippi.
Oh, it's not too far away to be thinking about Trenton and Corinth, too, because that'll be here before you know it. Oh, it's fun. How time flies when you're having fun. Hey, I'll tell you what, we've still got plenty of action to go, and we're going to take time out right now. Be back in just a moment. Scott Bowden seems to make himself attached to any place that there's difficulty and problem. He's hanging out with Gilbert and Rich, hanging out with Armstrong and Smothers. And here he comes bringing in what? Got to be the mailbag with all of your fans writing.
That's exactly right, Lance Russell. Yeah. You know, Tex Schlesinger has got to be the stupidest man to ever come from the state of Texas, and that includes Dusty Rhodes and the Von Erichs. Because you see, he thought that he was embarrassing me last week by pulling down my pants in front of all these idiots over here. But hey, baby, look at this. Look at my mailbag this week. I got about 1,000 marriage proposals in here, and there's one very, very special letter in here.
Not.
I'm going to have to run it past the network censors before I read it, but next week I'm going to read this letter live on television. How about that, Lance Russell?
And no, you know, it's not going to happen.
I want Randy Hales right out here right now. The big boss man, the man who thinks he's the boss. Come on out here, Forrest Gump. Run, Forrest! Run, Forrest!
If he comes running out here, he ought to be running right for your throat with what you and those thugs do.
I've taken $2,500 out of my trust fund, and I'm putting it on the line. I got a man that's going to teach you a lesson. We set the rules around here. We don't follow them. You understand me, punk?
Sure don't follow.
That's right, Lance. You don't follow it. Scott, you made your challenge. You threw your money out. I don't know what your problem is, but we have a television show to run today. We got matches that the people want to say. So all I'm
telling you, they want to see Scott Bowden. That's what they
want to
see.
I'm not going to get in an argument with you. All I'm telling you is to leave this TV studio so Lance can
Oh, you got to make me? You got to make me, Randy?
Don't push
Randy's
me,
getting
Scott
kind of, oh, don't mess with me. Yeah, what are you going to do, buddy?
From behind, Brandon Baxter sails in and nails Hales right in the back. Bender come flying out here, and that gets rid of Brandon Baxter and Scott Bowden. It's Randy. Dave, let's take a break right here. We'll check Randy out and be back in a moment. Well, we got the answer to one of the problems that we had in there, and that is, who was Scott Bowden bringing in for the Randy Hales?
Get out of your chair, huh?
I want to tell you one thing. That kind of an attitude, your stay around here is not going to be very long.
Oh, the boy is back in town. First of all, I want to give you people something you haven't seen in a while. This 150-pound rock-hard body. Take a look at that. Now, you know something? People have been saying to me, Brandon Baxter, where have you been? For the last 3 months, you haven't been in the USWA. Let me tell you a little story, and let me tell you why. Because from the very first day I came to this television studio, Randy Hales hated my stinking guts. I told you people I was going to manage tag team champions, and I did just that. I told you I was going to manage the USWA heavyweight champion, and I did just that. And what started to happen was Randy Hales got a little bit jealous, because he likes to tell people he's the boss of the USWA. Shut up! But what happened was Brandon Baxter came to the USWA and took over, and Randy Hales hated it. Well, Randy Hales, I was out, but now I'm back, as you can see, and I look even better than ever. And Randy Hales, what you just received was just a little bit, just a sample, what you could call a warning. Because Randy Hales, Brandon Baxter is back, and I will not be content with bruising Randy Hales or breaking his arms or legs. I won't even be happy to put him out of the USWA. I want to put him in a wheelchair. And I'm going to do it, because brick by brick, the foundation of the USWA will crumble until standing atop the rubble is Brandon Baxter once again.
Yeah, I noticed you jumped him from behind. It sure wasn't any one-on-one, face-to-face type thing. Brandon Baxter, to brighten our day one more time, yeah, Dave.
Not only was it not one-on-one and jumped from behind, but Scott Bowden was holding him up part of the time,
sure,
too. Well, I tell you. 7:30 Wednesday night, Mid-South Coliseum. Big action coming up here, and as you were talking about just then, one of the questions is answered. First match of the night, Border Patrol. Patricia was out here a little bit earlier talking about them. I haven't seen the Border Patrol, but I tell you what, she says they're coming in looking for tag titles. Well, it's not a title match they're in Wednesday night, but it is going against the Spellbinder and Tony Williams Wednesday night, the 24th, at the Coliseum.
USWA ladies title match. It'll be Miss Texas going against Patricia Surprise, and that is going to be Susan Sapphire. Mm-hmm.
Scott Bowden's $2,500 challenge match. We now know that Randy Hales is going to be facing Brandon Baxter. It's personal with Brandon Baxter. He doesn't like Randy Hales for what reasons he just said out here. Randy will have to face him in the ring, $2,500 at stake.
And you take a big old pole, tie a bull whip up on the top, and set Brian Christopher and Coco Beware right there, saying if you can get it, you can use it. That's what's going to be happening in the bullwhip on the pole match.
And the Grudge USW Tag Team title match. Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert with Scott Bowden in their corner, challenging the champions PG-13. But remember, this is very important. J.C. Ice's leg is hurt, and the action here today didn't do it one bit of good, let me tell you.
Don't know whether that one's going to be able to take place as we just said it right here or not. Non-sanctioned eight-man marathon match, 30 minutes in time. Whichever team can get the most falls within a 30-minute time period, that's who will be the winner. It is a falls count anywhere. Two referees will be assigned, because it's bring anything, use anything. When Tommy Rich, Doug Gilbert, Tracy Smothers, and Jesse James Armstrong face PG-13, Too Sexy, Brian Christopher, and the Mystery Partner. Wednesday night, 7:30, Mid-South Coliseum. Going to be a scrapping night of action, David.
Here's Wolfie D along with Brian Christopher. I noticed JC is not with them. They are tending to that leg, but, yeah, legs hurt pretty bad, Wolfie says.
That's right. Doug Gilbert You know, Brian, I should have listened to you a long time ago, man. You were right about that Doug Gilbert. He's nothing but a snake in the grass. And see, Doug Gilbert, we had our run-in in the past. And this week, when it comes to that marathon match, I ain't going to forget the stuff that happened. You remember when you put my eye out? You remember when you shaved our heads, punched my mother, and now you tried to break my partner's leg? Well, we got a marathon match. That means a guaranteed 30 minutes of butt-kicking, baby. And I know who's going to be doing the butt-kicking. Now, Doug Gilbert, we got a surprise partner, man, but Brian's going to tell you all about that. But I just got one thing to say about the surprise partner. Brother, it's bad, baby.
Dave, backstabbers and people that have to jump people from behind, that's what we got around here. Doug Gilbert, Tracy Smothers, Armstrong, and Coco Beware. Well, Coco Beware, I'm going to get my hands on you before this big match. It's a bullwhip on the pole, and I just can't wait because you've jumped me from behind time and time again and beat me with the bullwhip. Well, this week, Coco Ware, I swear you can bring me a Bible that I am going to beat you senseless with that bullwhip until I see some of your stinking blood running down your back. Then you're going to have to come back out there. Because after that, we got one of the biggest matches. This Wednesday night at the Coliseum is going to be one of the greatest nights in my life. There's going to be destruction galore because PG-13 and myself, we're having problems, right? There's four of them, but there's three of us. Well, Downtown Bruno came to me and said, I got somebody in mind that would love to be you guys' partner. And he has been in here before, and he has beat people's brains out. Broken thousands of bones, Jerry Lawler, all the big stars. This man has been in here and caused a lot of havoc. And I got a tape of him. I want you to roll this tape and take a look. You see that?
The Ugandan giant, Kamala.
That's what you got to look forward to, Coco Ware. Look into them eyes. Look into them eyes, nobody is home. And he loves nothing more than to hurt people and hurt them bad. And he's going to be on our side this Wednesday night. We're going all over the building. Anything goes. Nobody is stopping this match until this man right here is through with you. Until we beat you as long as we want to beat you. It's going all night long. A marathon match with Kamala, the Ugandan giant, along with PG-13 and Brian Christopher. Nobody, I mean nobody, is going to stop the giant when he's got Brian Christopher and PG-13 behind him. So get ready. It's going to be destruction, pain.
We're going to do it. Brian Christopher, Kamala, and PG-13, we're going to take them to school because we cool like the water in the swimming pool, baby.
We're going to hurt you.
Kamala, certainly a formidable addition to the team in that marathon match which is coming up. We'll be back here with more right after this.
I finally got the handcuffs off. I feel so sorry for him. Look at that back. Oh, his back is shredded.
Coco.
Ripley print. Yeah. Let's take a look at Wednesday night as we once again will remind you, Wednesday night, Mid-South Coliseum, 7:30 is the bell time. You can get your tickets at the Coliseum and all Ticketmaster locations. And we'll be opening up with a brand new team of the Border Patrol and Patricia going against the Spellbinder and Tony Williams.
Then the USWA ladies title is on the line. Patricia has brought in her surprise. Turns out to be Susan Sapphire, who will be challenging Miss Texas, the ladies' title on the line.
And to fill in another blank, Scott Bowden's $2,500 challenge match with Randy Hales. Randy's opponent, going to be Brandon Baxter.
Bullwhip on a pole, too sexy Brian Christopher will be going against Coco Ware, and I think Coco will find Brian's a much tougher opponent than the young man he just had in here.
USWA tag title match with PG-13 defending against Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert.
Then, non-sanctioned eight-man marathon match, falls count anywhere, two referees, bring anything, use anything. Whoever wins the most falls in 30 minutes wins the match. Tommy Rich, Doug Gilbert, Tracy Smothers, Jesse James Armstrong against PG-13, too sexy Brian Christopher and their special partner Kamala.
Do it again. Join us out there Wednesday night. We got to get out of here. For Corey Macklin, Dave Brown, Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.